Good morning. I'm Gileard Masenga, obstetrician and gynecologist, KCMC, and also the head of department of obstetric and gynecology. So I'll give this talk on cervical cancer, and I'll mainly concentrate on our experience in cancer of the cervix, prevention of the cancer of the cervix and treatment. So this is the outline of the presentation. There'll be some introduction, a little bit of epidemiology and the statistics, our screening modality and treatment of both precancerous lesion and invasive cancer of the cervix. What do we do here in KCMC? So cancer of the cervix is still a global problem. We saw it in the initial presentation, and we see almost 500,000 new cases worldwide. And as you can see, Africa, especially Sub-Saharan Africa and South Central Asia, are more affected with cancer of the cervix. So when it comes into death, every minute a new case of cancer of the cervix is diagnosed worldwide. And we have death in every 2 minutes. And when we see about the incidence and number of deaths, in Latin America, 43% of all those who are diagnosed with cancer of the cervix died. And in Europe, about 48% of those who are diagnosed with cancer of the cervix, they die also. 54% in Asia, and in Africa, we have more people dying after diagnosis of cancer of the cervix. So in Africa, there is similar distribution of mortality in Africa, but, you see East Africa, especially Tanzania, Zambia, we have more mortality, and part of West Africa. In Tanzania, mortality rates, we talk about 37.5 per 100,000 women. We saw this statistic earlier in this presentation. Also in Zambia, the situation is similar, but in North Africa, the situation is much far better. So the Eastern and Southern Africa, the standardized incidence rate is 90 per 1,000 women per year. In Uganda, we talk about 50 per 100,000 per year. And in Tanzania, the documented incidence rate in Tanzania is 50.9 per 100,000 women per year. So how about screening program? At KCMC, we started our cervical cancer screening program in 2005. And this was through the help of WHO, and later with Duke University came in to assist us. And in our program, of course, we go according to WHO and also Tanzania guideline. But at KCMC, we start a little bit earlier in screening, around 25 years, because of our experience. We've seen some women coming with invasive cancer of the cervix even below 30 years. So we said, although WHO recommendation is 30 years and our guideline, we start a little bit earlier. So we screen every 3 years for those who are found without any problem, with no any history of high-grade lesion. So when they come, we screen them, and if they have no more finding, they are being given appointment after 3 years. Our screening clinic is just outside of this building, and normally we run our clinic twice a week, every Tuesday and Thursday, and women are invited voluntarily, and treatment is free. Services are offered free. Patients only pay for investigation. So, and normally they don't need to present with a file, collect file. So they just come there, the first come, first served. This is how we operate. So for those who are immunosuppressed, HIV positive patient, or those who are in any form of immunosuppressed treatment, the screening is on annual basis. And we stop screening at the age of 65, 70 years, if they have three previous consecutive negative or normal pap smear or history, no history of abnormal screening for the last 10 years. So our screening modality here at KCMC, we have visual inspection technique, like VIA, this is visual inspection with acetic acid painting, and visual inspection with Lugo's iodine painting. Also, we do cytology, pap smear, colposcopy, cervical biopsy. So this we have not started, but there's a WHO project which is coming up with the Minister of Health, and KCMC has been selected as one of the sites as a pilot. This will be a pilot study for HPV DNA testing. And also, we do cervicography. So we started cervicography screening since 2011, and I think this is the only site in Tanzania where we do cervicography. So the visual inspection technique, acetic acid painting, normally these are the basic, and those abnormal cells will turn, all these plastic cells, the normal turn acid white phenomena, and this is due to high protein content in these plastic cells. And with the VLI, or visual inspection with Lugo iodines, the precancerous lesions, they turn yellow. And normal cells, they turn blue-black due to glycogen content. So our visual inspection techniques, they are really sensitive according to research. So VIA, the sensitivity is about 77%, and specificity, almost 86%. And VLI is around 92%. So the advantage, we all know the advantage of this technique, and that's why our Minister of Health and Social Welfare has adopted the visual inspection techniques, because